Welcome to a presentation slides add-on tutorial where we talk about a Bforartists 4 default add-on for presentation slides. So what is the add-on? This add-on takes scene content and then converts it into a slide for a presentation. It will play back one scene animation from the first frame to the end frame and then pause, and then with a button it will also activate onto the next slide. So how to activate the add-on? First, go to the Edit menu, then go to the User Preferences. Then search for the add-on Presentation, slide it underneath the Add-ons tab, and activate it. This will create a new panel that you can pin or use to control your slides. So how to use this add-on? Step 1. Set up the scenes. A scene is a collection that contains all of your objects, your cameras, your text, and animation inside of the file. When you have a scene ready, you can duplicate it. This will link in collections or create new collections within your scene. To assist with managing scenes, switch the Properties Editor to the bottom right to the Outliner, and then change it the Display Mode to Scenes. You can alternatively use the top bar and use the Scene drop-down toggle from the miscellaneous toolbar group. Once you have a scene selected, you have the option of changing your scenes here, which are your slides, and from there assigning collections that are linked to different scenes, for example this blue common collection right here, or a custom collection with new content here. So in this case we can duplicate a linked copy, or copy the settings of the scene or delete them, or make a full copy to create a new slide. So we're going to use a linked copy. We're going to rename this into scene 5. And with the scene copy, we're going to duplicate this collection, hide number 4, name the duplicated collection 5, and change the content. So now that we have changed the content, we'll go through the other scenes to hide the new collection, just to assign the correct slide. There are a number of different ways of doing this. And from there, we can now see that we have new scenes. The next step is to animate your content. Each scene has a timeline, and this timeline contains a start frame and an end frame. When you animate your content for your scenes, you will animate from point A to point B, switch the scene, then animate from point B to point C. When you have your animation and your scenes ready, then you move on to step 3 and you present the slides, where you can use the buttons previous and the next, which will add a hook to the playback so that it stops on the final frame, and this will change your scenes forward or backwards based on alphabetical order. You can also reset your animation to loop again, which will reset the looping and plays your current scene. You can also hide the interface by maximizing your viewport, or using a full screen view mode, or using the hide interface operator, which hides based on toolbar display and maximizes it and hides the sidebars. I highly recommend you map the forward and backwards to a hotkey by right-clicking on the operator and using it. So as a summary, set up your scenes, animate your content from point A to B and B to C, and then present the slides. Enjoy this with Bforartists 4 today. It's free.